I did my greatest work back here, yes. You haven't heard of it, but it'll come out someday. It's the novel called Darrow. Now, the way we did it was we'd pin things to the top of the, underneath the table, and we'd lie down there and we'd read off of them, and to have, do a little DMT and read into the tape recorder, and we'd Darrow emerged. And Darrow lives still right here.
There is a road, no simple highway between the dawn and the dark of night. And if you go, no one may follow. That path is for your steps alone. Ripple in still water, when there is no pebble tossed, no wind to blow. You choose to lead, must follow. But if you fall, you fall alone. If you should stand, then who's to guide you? If I knew the way, I would take you home. La da da da, la da da da, la da da da, la da 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 da, la da 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 da, la da.
Well, we need to get over there.
I think we need
There's
more cheerleaders.
There's a large group of cheerleaders over there
on the bus,
on the fun bus.
In the 60s, there were a lot of cheerleaders.
And Ken is explaining to them, even as we speak.
And they've been learning their moves. They've been working hard on their little
acts. And Ken is showing them all his best moves.
I want to help them if I can. If I can help them get a job in television, I want to help them.
A job is what they need.
This is George Bush on the campus of Stanford University, giving my inaugural address on peace and prosperity to all of nation as it emanates from these girls.
That was awfully appropriate for the Furthur book to be here at Stanford University with the Five Fives.
Nice one. Thank you so much.
Guys, Suzanne Egan did it.
Go on.
Everyone should read it. If Five Eyes of Stanford read it, we're going to take it home. This is our copy. Get one for yourself.
I went to Stanford. They didn't know that, did they? No, but actually I did go to Stanford. Working on my master's degree here, but they made me take an oral French exam, and I walked in there. They handed me a book of French, and I said, oh yes, I recognize this. Hemingway's Lost Andes Expedition. They looked at them, said, get rid of this guy. And they only let you do it once a year. Next year, where was I? Gone to the Marine Corps. So long to education. So that's the story of my life. I'm glad you were all here to share it with me.
We're ready to roll here, Ken.
The way the sunlight plays upon our
bus comes away.
Walk away from that.
On the wind that lifts her perfume through the air.
I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. I'm picking up good vibrations.
Good vibrations.
Softly smile, I know she must be kind. In her eyes, she goes with me to a blossom room.
I'm picking up good vibrations, she's giving me the excitations. I'm picking up good vibrations, she's by my
up to the light and turn left. Up to the light and turn left. And up to the light we turn left. Go up to the light and turn left.
Left to the light, turn left.
Into the left.
Go up to the light, turn left.
Into the left.
Go up to the light and make your left. There they go, left.
Left to the light.
Up to the light, turn left.
Turn left,
turn left, turn left.
Turn left, turn left. Go up to the light.
Left,
why does it say right turn only?
Yep.
Okay, he's gone.
Now, who's with me, mates? Okay, here's the plan, then.
Okay. That's enough. Now we will sing our national anthem. Which I have learned that just about everybody knows. It goes, sometimes a life's all shining on me. Other times I can barely see. Lately it occurs to me, what a long, strange trip it's been. Thank you.
Hey,
so who's with us?
Get off of here.
Hagen's out.
Get him out of here.
Get Hagen out of here.
Throw him out in the dirt.
The geezers stay. We don't need no stinking writers. We can make our own movie.
Hurry up, he's almost out.
Well, that's enough of that. Come on, we don't want to call attention to ourselves.
Burn the place down. Okay, let's go.
I don't know what I'm going to do with you.
Tippy almost misses the bus.
So,
let's go.
Oh, Jesus.
Hey, how are we going to get out of here with this painted up bus anyway?
Who did that? Who was that? Let's go in the right direction. We're on the road.
Definitely go the right direction.
On the road again.
That's that. Bounce it off. What do you, how does it feel, Roy? To be part of this,
feels sticky on one side and smooth on the other.
Come on, pull the
baby bubble, baby bubble, baby bubble.
Yeah.
what I think we ought to do is just paint the bus, man. Nobody will know what it looks like.
Just paint it.
Nobody will recognize it. Just paint it.
Okay.
Just paint it cheap paint.
Oh, they'll love this.
Yeah. Situation.
Just look for a place that's lit.
It's easy. Ken Kesey, your bus is gone. There's nothing but a chalk outline. And some sparklers.
Babs, what's going on? Fill us in.
I don't know, kids up here straining at gnats. The wind's about 27 knots.
Where are we?
Where we're gonna go unless we get some shots.
Where are we? What are we doing?
Question, where are we? We're here in Frog City with the wind coming through here about 17 croaks per second.
What's Kit doing?
What's Kit doing? Kit is doing the exercise up there. Without this, the bus won't start. He turns this thing and it creates a vacuum inside.
Is this some kind of conspiracy?
Is this
some kind of conspiracy?
It is, yes.
Of course
it's a conspiracy. What the hell do you think's going on around here, for crying out loud?
It's all
what is it?
Jesus, look at that.
Where'd you guys lift this bus? Is painted more and more blue. We will be blue. The Silver Surfer goes blue. The ocean turns to blue. Everything's blue. We're not artists now. We are blue. We are the Blue Meanies.
Turn the bus around and come into it from the other direction. We got to make sure that in case that we're spotted, that nobody can tell who we are.
What do you mean?
Turn the bus around and paint the other side now.
Last night, I swear to God, this was right here. This was the bus. This is where I was sitting, right here, amidships. I used to have a beanbag right here. It's gone. The damn thing's gone. The only evidence that's left here is chalk outline of a bus and nothing left. Boss, I swear to God, there was a bus. I didn't spend all that money, all that expense money on nothing. There was a bus, see? Ask them. There was a bus.
There was a bus. It was full of old geezers.
Geezer bus.
It was full of geezers. And then it left us.
By the way, Kesey, your fly's on stiff. Another dud. Another geezer dud.
Another geezer dud.
It was fun while lasting.
Remember all you out there.
wondering about.
No secret messages. Don't try to slip out some coded medicine.
Okay, Johnny. Sorry.
Or you'll be out there cleaning.
That's Johnny. You know, of course, that's his fake name. He lets me call him Johnny. I think he likes me. Yeah. I tell my story.
We have abducted this man. We found him sleeping.
Okay.
He was not enjoying this bus like it was supposed to.
No, not like it's just fun or something.
We've taken him because we have no women.
Oh, really? Oh, really? Hey, wait a minute. There are some things even hostages won't bend over for. Oh. I'm sorry, Johnny.
Damn you, Babs. It's
quite all right.
Babses.
Well, you know how we are. In Babs land.
Take that!
Ah!
Take it, Babs.
Here we go.
Fix that sound system, Babs.
How we doing, Johnny?
I think good I fixed now, Babs. Get back in your seat.
Sit
good work.
Back down there.
Okay, I will. And I promise never to be a bad boy
don't
again.
Don't do that again.
I know. Me? Me,
get
Johnny?
No stinky dinner.
Okay, Johnny boy. He thinks that I did that.
Hey.
See, it shows you.
Sit down there.
Oh, okay, Johnny. Okay.
Hey. Don't you show those stars on that guy. You sit down.
All right, folks.
Stop up here at the phone booth. They're making me the message. It's making Babs be the message.
Yeah, don't have that up there.
Yeah.
Come on, you sneaky rider. Get in here and make this phone call! Get in here! Hey, Ken,
nobody move! We're not afraid to use this! Get in here!
Don't
try anything funny!
Does that hurt?
This is Ken Babs calling.
Just read this.
They have me. A message for Charles Kuwalt.
Read that.
They have me. They are forcing me to read this statement. The statement they say, we are jealous of all the attention these old fart pranksters have got. And we have had enough. Mutiny.
Yes, mutiny.
We are safely, en route.
Come on, just read the words.
Do not cancel the credit cards or you will never see Babs again.
Give me that phone. And we don't need no stinking riders and we'll be back to you later. You'll hear from us, the Furthur gang.
This just in. Ken Kesey's psychedelic bus Furthur, made famous in the 1960s for going cross-country with his merry band of pranksters, has been apprehended. The bus was en route to the Smithsonian Museum in Washington, D.C., where it was to be placed on a permanent exhibit. Furthur had recently undergone a major facelift for the trip, returning it to mint condition. The multicolored 1939 International Harvester school bus was last seen heading toward the Mexican border.
Alas, I have failed anew. With final hopes for glory and immortality no longer, I am doomed to travel through time on shapeless beasts, never more to have the wind in my face, never to taste the sweet song of victory, nor drink upon the wines of success. All hope is lost. My final journey is undone, like so many before it. Fate has played its part in my destiny, and for the faithful I leave you with this newfound wisdom. Remember, it is not where your journey ends, nor what your vehicle looks like, but how you travel, that is forever.
Oh.
Smithsonian wants a magic bus. Mileage. Pumpkin mileage. Wants a magic bus.
Watch the wires here too, lots of low wires.
Watch the cars and the wires.
The sound is wires. Got the cars and the wires.
I realized that the school bus is a modern primal image, just like an elk used to be.
Here's where the railroad used to be. We shouldn't bump any second.
People try to put us down.
Watch your heads.
Whoa. Just because I'm
those are pretty low trees there, boy.
Watch it, we got more.
Hope I die before I get old.
Well, not me. I was hoping to stick around.
You guys are already old. Watch your heads up here, boys.
Hey, kid, we're watching our next landmark. It's Martin Luther King Jr. Way. And we're turning right. It'll be a little bit more.
Talking about my generation.
You better grab this mic.
Hold on. Are we talking about my generation or your generation?
Well,
okay, Captain.
Our generation.
Give them down our generators.
Our
generation.
Our generator.
Our generator.
Generator. Talking about my generator.
Talking about my generator.
Talking about my Honda generator.
Batteries. Talk about my batteries.
4,000 watts of portable power. Runs on a gallon for just about
watch
an hour.
Watch the trees now. Watch them.
I think we're reinforcing the prototype.
Hidden in the heart of the woods, we find famous Pranksters bus, School of the Dumb. Lizard fighting his way. Still living through the primal colors. Yes, hidden quietly here, the stolen Prankster bus. Will it ever hit the road again? Will it ever roll through its great glories in Berkeley, San Francisco, find its way to the Honkonian? Broken windshield, old Furthur sits quietly, trying to look like its previous bus, like the first Furthur. Doves and swallows trying to fight their way through the blue camouflage paint. They didn't paint this side very good. Helium tanks that made many children smile with their balloons disguised here in the...
What was those,
if you eat enough of them, you get really, really sweet. You probably already sweet though.